Here we will explore true facts about the sea slug. The scientific name for sea slug is nudibranch, and while most of them are in fact nude, they bear no resemblance to branches. I don't know what scientists are thinking coming up with these kinds of names, but it sure does seem fun. What about Yoda purpurata? Now, you might think I just made this up, but there is actually a really strange worm at the bottom of the ocean with this exact name, and I don't think I'm allowed to draw it in any more detail than this. This is my friend Wilbur. Wilbur is a vivid sea slug from the family Chromorodididae. He is one of the most colorful sea slugs I've ever seen, which says a lot considering all sea slugs are covered in only the most vibrant of colors. Very impressive, Wilbur. However, most sea slugs are actually born quite pale. You see, apart from being incredibly pretty, Wilbur is actually a most devious sea slug. This sprawling gentleman here is a hydroid. At first glance, he might look like a friendly little seaweed, but don't be fooled by his appearance though. This is actually a close relative to the lethal jellyfish. They are covered in spring-loaded spikes called nematocysts that detonate on contact. This does not intimidate the brave Wilbur, however. Unscathed by the venom, he slugs his way right up to Mr. Hydroid to eat his venomous weaponry. The nematocysts that don't trigger immediately are then stored in the spikes on Wilbur's back for later use. This, my friends, is where sea slugs get their colors. Sea slugs come in many different shapes and sizes, the blue dragon sea slug being one of the more interesting ones. Meet my friend Myla. Sea dragons spend most of the time using the surface tension of the water to fly over the peasants of the ocean floor, just like a real dragon would. But that's not all. You see, Myla's favorite food is actually the Portuguese man-o-war, which is one of the most venomous jellyfish in the entire ocean. Even though Myla is of the most dangerous species of sea slug, she doesn't feel the need to boast about it with fancy colors like the pretentious Wilbur. Instead, she blends in with the surface of the water using a technique known as countershading. Very clever, Myla. This right here is my favorite species of sea slug. Her name is Scarlet and she is a sea bunny. While she might not be quite as vibrant as her other friends, she makes up for it with pure fluff. The sea bunny slug has two black little ears and a fuzzy tail, just like the far less exciting land bunny. Unlike the land bunny, however, the sea bunny uses its tail for breathing, instead of whatever the land bunny uses it for. I mean seriously, what evolutionary advantage led to bunnies having worthless balls of fluff on their a**? Beneath all that fluff though, Scarlet is actually a vicious predator, which would be terrifying if you were a sponge. Sea slugs truly are some of the most wonderful creatures in the ocean, and I love them. And that is how the sea slug do.